Rearing above the Gothic sprawl of Edinburgh is the stony edifice of Edinburgh Castle, one of the oldest fortifications in Europe. Standing on the plug of an extinct volcano, the castle has existed in various forms for thousands of years. A Bronze Age hill fort gave way to a royal residence, which then became a military garrison, and so on and so forth over the years, until we end up in the 21st century, with this rather imposing and rather expensive tourist attraction. Naturally, a site with such a long history has a wealth of ghosts and stories to accompany it. One tale that you'll hear in various forms is that of the Lost Piper. The story, which has many variations, generally goes something like this. Several hundred years ago, a network of tunnels were discovered under Edinburgh Castle, leading down the Royal Mile towards Holyrood Palace. A young piper was sent down into the dark to explore them. The plan was that he would play his pipes at full volume as he wandered the darkened labyrinth beneath the city, which would allow people on the surface to follow along and map exactly where the tunnels were leading. This worked out for at least a little while, until the poor piper got about halfway down the mile towards the palace, at which point the sound of bagpipes abruptly ceased. Fearing the worst, a search party was sent down into the catacombs, but came back empty-handed. The young piper appeared to have disappeared. Of course, the tunnels were then sealed up and never reopened. But some claim, if you listen carefully, you can sometimes still hear the mournful wail of bagpipes emanating from beneath the cobbles of Edinburgh's old town. The lost piper forever wandering those sealed and forgotten tunnels. If that wasn't spooky enough, within the castle itself, you may also spot an apparition that people refer to as the Grey Lady. Dressed in the garb of a 16th century noblewoman, she's been seen wandering the older parts of the castle, lamenting and weeping. The Grey Lady is thought to be the ghost of one Lady Janet Douglas, a woman who was burned at the stake on the esplanade outside the castle in 1537. Like most women burned at the stake throughout history, she was, of course, innocent. Lady Janet was nonetheless accused of attempting to poison King James V, an accusation that was 100% fabricated by King James himself. King James was kind of salty towards Janet's whole family, ever since her brother had married his mum and ruled the kingdom that was rightfully his for a number of years. After the king rose to power and Lady Janet's family fled Scotland, King James decided to take it out on the unfortunate Miss Douglas and burned her at the stake. Tragic as the story of the Grey Lady might be, there's another ghost that's sometimes seen, or at least smelled, around the castle, whose tales elicit rather less sympathy. Visitors often report the smell of manure around the battlements of the castle, sometimes accompanied by the sight of a raggedly dressed man who, on occasion, has even tried to push people over the edge. The story behind this spectre is a rather unglamorous one. The man is thought to have been a prisoner in the dark, dank dungeons of the castle. In an escape attempt gone wrong, he stowed away in a barrow of manure, anticipating that he'd be dumped somewhere beyond the walls and could then make good his stinky escape. However, rather than being wheeled out to a dung heap and dumped there, the barrow was instead upended over the battlements of the castle, sending the unfortunate escapee to his death on the jagged rocks below. A rather ignoble end for a prisoner who at least showed a fair bit of ingenuity. Anywho, those are just a few of the strange spectres that visitors to Edinburgh Castle report seeing, hearing, feeling, and smelling. Given just how old the site is, there are bound to be at least a few more. Have you visited? And did you see anything if you did? Let us know in the comments. Bye!